One of your motors isn't spinning. Don't you hate when that happens? You never know. Is it motor? Is it speed controller? Wiring? Flight controller? Well, let me show you how we test out flight controllers. And I think you'll be a little bit surprised at what happens at the end. I'm David from Rotorgeeks, and today I'm going to show you how to test the motor outputs of your flight controller with just a multimeter. It's very simple to do. You just need to get set up with a computer and Betaflight configurator, get your multimeter set to DC voltage, plug everything in, and then let's just get a baseline reading. We can take the ground and put it onto any ground pin at all on the control board. And this is the Rotorgeeks SSD, so our motor outputs are running across the top here. I'm just going to put the red onto output number one. Look over at the multimeter and I see that we have 1.58 volts. I'll just bounce over to 2, 3, and 4, see if we've got all the same things going on. There's number 2, number 3, number 4, and just for fun, let's go over to number 5. And when my multimeter starts jumping around like that, it means it has no reading at all. So we've got no output on 5 and no output on 6, but that's okay because we're flying a quadcopter. So now we know we've got at least the baseline output. Let's move into the motor sliders and see if we get a variability as motor output goes up. Go into Betaflight configurator, turn on motor control, and we can just reattach our leads so that we'll be monitoring voltage on the meter. And I'll now go into the master slider and increase the output. And you see voltage going up. At full throttle, we're at 3.16, which just happens to be double the value of no throttle, 1.58. So we can see that as we slide up and down, the voltage is changing in a proportional way, and that motor output is working fine. And then we can just move across, do the same thing to check number 2, number 3, number 4, and if you find one that isn't moving properly or isn't giving the same level of voltage out, then that would be a problem. If you want to chase it a little bit further down the line, this feeds into your speed controller. So if there was a wiring problem, we could measure that voltage level down at the speed controller side. And if there was any issue with the wiring, it would appear there. And I know a lot of you smarty pants guys are thinking, ah, yes, that'll work with PWM signals, good old fashioned analog. But we all use Dshot now. Digital doesn't go that way. How are we gonna test this out? Well, you know what? I thought the exact same thing. Let's just pop over to the configurator and we'll change the ESC protocol. The first test was run in PWM. I just chose that because it gives a really nice big fat voltage and it's easy to see. So we're going to select Dshot 150. And before we save it, I'm just going to put the probes back on the board so you can watch the change. So ground anywhere, I'll monitor motor output 1. And we're back at the 1.58 volts. Now I'm gonna save the changes to Dshot 150 and see what happens to our voltage. And the board is initialized and stable. And now we're looking at 233, 234 millivolts. And we are in the digital domain. So tell me, what do you think is going to happen when we move over to the motor sliders? All you digital guys, I know you're going to tell me that ones carry the same voltage as zeros, right? Nothing's going to happen. All right, let's check it out. Master slider up. We are at 234, and here we go. And now we're at 409 millivolts.
Damn!
Let's bring it to like maybe roughly halfway. .382 millivolts. The digital signal actually varies up and down, just like an analog signal. My guess is that in the communication of a long stream of ones, as opposed to zeros, which is what's going on when we're at full throttle, Those ones are carrying a high signal, averaged out by the multimeter to be a higher voltage level. You can use this technique to troubleshoot any flight controller in any ESC protocol. I hope you found that helpful. Thanks for watching. For more tips and tricks on troubleshooting your quad, subscribe to the channel.